Good day. Welcome to all of you. Myself, Dr. Arvind Sharma, Associate Professor in Physics, Government Dugar College, Bikaner. My today's lecture topic is two-cavity klystron. Its construction and working. Students, please point to be noted that in your syllabus, it is quoted that two-cavity klystron. And in next points, velocity modulation and its work. So there are three type of questions. First is construction and working of two-cavity klystron. Second one is velocity modulation, and third one is a combined question can be asked related with electron bunching, velocity modulation, etc. So let us start with the initially what is the two-cavity klystron. In this PDF, I collected the material from different streams and different kinds of expressions or different kinds of explanation is given. So I incorporated in this PDF many kinds of approaches. So you just study. Here I suggest you that when you read an article from somewhere, you read that article, that means you study that article from different approaches. Then what is the profit of this? You just revise your topic, and which are the new things you incorporate, you know, in your notes. So you read all articles which I uploaded or submitted to you on your WhatsApp or on our YouTube channel. You just go through all the topic so you understand the topic clearly. So let us start today's topic, two cavity klystron, its working and construction. Okay, here I again suggest you that the approach of physics is that is to understand the construction and working and physical mechanism of the system, because all topics in this paper related to technology, radar system, satellite system, microwave communication, microwave devices. So there is a vast literature about that. So don't worry about that. You just concise to the points like construction, working and physical mechanism. Okay. So let us start. What is the definition? Klystrons are special type of vacuum tubes. Special type of vacuum tubes, not vacuum tubes, special types of vacuum tubes that find applications as amplifier and oscillators at microwave frequencies. At microwave frequencies, they applied as amplifiers and oscillators. Its principle of operation is velocity modulation. We read it in next few lectures. What is velocity modulation? What is current modulation? Thus, the device used for amplifying microwave signals is known as two-cavity klystron because it has two cavities, which we understand clearly when we see its construction and working. In the year of 1937, American engineers Russell and Sigward Varian developed klystron. Okay. Basically, the operating principle of klystron is such that the kinetic energy of a moving electron beam, is utilized for amplifying generating microwave signals. What is the basic principle? Kinetic energy of a moving electron beam utilized for amplifying and generating microwave signals. Traveling wave tubes are also used for amplification of RF signals and have similar applications as klystrons. We study this topic also, traveling wave tube. But in traveling wave tube, a continuous interaction is maintained. Between the field and electron beam. A continuous interaction is maintained. And what is in klystron? Interaction between two is allowed to occur only at the cavities of the structure. Not in the space between them. That is drift-free space. We can understand easily. Now, klystrons are majorly classified as two cavity klystron and reflex klystron. Both questions are important for you. Here, in this article, we will discuss the construction and working of the two cavity klystron and its amplification. What are the contents? What is the operating principle? Again, point to be noted that for a physics student, operating principle is most important part. Construction, working, and its applications. There are four parts you should understand about operating, about klystrons. Operating principle of two cavity klystron. First point, okay, as we have already discussed in the introduction, that klystrons used the principle of velocity modulation, and two cavity klystron utilizes the kinetic energy of the moving electron beam for signal amplification. What is the aim for signal amplification? What we are using? Kinetic energy of moving electron beam for signal amplification. That is the very important point. Now, the variation in the velocity of electrons while moving inside the tube. When electrons are moving inside the tube, there is variation in the velocity, and that is known as velocity modulation. And velocity modulation permits bunching of electrons while propagation. So here we study also current modulation also, okay, because electrons are charged particles. So the combined energy of bunched electrons is transferred at the output, thereby providing an amplified signal. How we get the amplified signal? Combined energy of bunched electron is transferred at the output, so it provides us amplified signal. There are many kinds of figures showing the two cavity klystrons. I included 3-4 figures in this PDF, so you easily understand it. It doesn't matter that which article you can understand and how you explain your approach. Most important part is that you must understand it. Okay, so you choose any kind of approach and you explain your answer easily if you understand that. Okay, below the figure, which figure? Structure of two cavity klystron. Each part is well labeled. I again instruct you point to be noted that your figure should be well labeled, like that or like as you see the posters in your laboratories or anywhere. In poster you see every part of the figure is well labeled. So if you draw the well and cleaned and labeled diagram of any equipment or any device, then your 50% answer is completed. Because after that you must only, after that you just explain it, and that is very easy. Here I am just describing that what are the parts. First of all, starting from this heating element. Heating element is for cathode, because you all know that cathode is a heating cathode. There is in many books the name given heated cathode. Okay, so heated cathode emits the electron. Okay, after that you are seeing here focusing electrode. What is the use of focusing electrodes? Focusing electrodes focuses the electron beam. After that, this portion is known as anode. Electron beams are passes through the anode. Okay, and after that, what is this? This is known as cavity. This part is known as cavity. First is known as Bunsen cavity, second is known as Kaiser cavity. This is first cavity, this is second cavity. Because it produces bunches of the electrons and it catches the electrons bunches. So the names are given as, this is resonant cavity is known as Bunsen cavity, and this is known as resonant cavity known as Kaiser cavity. Here RF input. In many figures, here shows microwave input, so it doesn't matter. So RF input is given to the Bunsen cavity. Okay. Now, this is a free space between two cavities. That is known as drift space. Drift space. And here electrons bunches are, that means electron bunching process occurs here. Okay, there is magnet system to control the electron bunching or this system, that means it provides the magnetic field. Electric field is provided from the applied potential. Here you see that a potential is applied here between the focusing electrodes and output of the klystron. Okay, so it accelerates the electrons. What is the aim of potential? You all of you know that if we apply potential V to a charged particle, it gains the energy QV. That means here is EV. And that energy gives the kinetic energy to the electrons. It is converted into the kinetic energy of the electrons, half mv square equal to EV. Okay, and that is this is the very small concept here. So this is the construction. That means what are the different parts and how we can understand the construction only. Now, what is the working? Electrons emitted from here and bunching process is occurs, and then after that kinetic energy of the electrons is given to the output, that means Kircher cavity. Okay, so what is the brief description of the working? First of all, okay, as we see, what we see that figure consists of two cavities, namely puncture cavity and Kircher cavity. RF signal to be amplified is provided at the puncture cavity. You just see that RF input is provided to the puncture cavity. Okay? And RF signal to be amplified. Electron gun comprises cathode, heating element and anode. Electron gun, how you produce electron gun? First, cathode emits the electrons, and the potential applied between cathode and anode accelerates the electrons, and we get the electron gun, that means accelerated electrons. The electron beam is produced by the cathode by making use of heating element and the high positive potential at the anode provides required acceleration to the electron beam initially. Point to be noted. Okay, this potential is especially applied between cathode and anode. Okay, the region between the two cavities is known as drift space. To allow focused propagation of electron beam inside the tube, an external electromagnetic winding is used that generates a longitudinal magnetic field. A very important point to be noted that To allow focused propagation of electron beam inside the tube, an external electromagnetic winding is used that generates a longitudinal magnetic field. Here we are using the magnetic system, and this magnetic system, what gives? Longitudinal magnetic field. This is done in order to prevent the spreading of the electron beam inside the tube. That means longitudinal magnetic field confines the electrons inside the tube and it prevents the spreading of the electron beam. Okay? The amplified RF signal is achieved at the Kircher cavity. What you get? Amplified RF signal achieved. Also, a collector is present near the second cavity that collects the electron bunch. Here is a collector. This is collector, and it collects the electron beam, so it is known as collector. This is not shown in this figure, so you just tried that this is collector, and now you easily understand that this potential is applied between the focusing electrodes and collector. Okay, now we want to understand the working of two cavity klystrons. So you just understand this article up to here today. Okay, in next lecture we understand the working of two cavity klystrons. Okay, but you see it clearly, try to understand the every step because this is very new concept for you. Okay, thank you all of you.